The following video was a true encounter from my sister that will be reenacted by a very good friend of mine.
This world is a strange one.
When DP was 6 years old, he came from a military family and was constantly moving around in the United States. His father just received orders to be stationed overseas in Okinawa, Japan, a country that DP was not too familiar with other than on television. It took him a while to get used to the customs and traditions and, you know, but eventually it did grow on him. At school, he would often hear stories of ghostly encounters from his classmates. And let's just say he was a bit of a wuss when it came to the supernatural, as ghosts and basically anything related to that scare the crap out of him. Heck, he couldn't even watch horror movies without having to hide his face under the blankets or near his parents. One hot Saturday morning, his parents had to visit his father's commander for a very important meeting, and they asked if he wanted to tag along, but he decided to stay home and basically told his parents,
"I'm a big boy. I can take care of myself."
Like any 6-year-old, he spent the entire afternoon playing video games, eating junk food, and reading manga. He basically had a very good time by himself. And then eventually he decided to go to the bathroom to take a bubble bath, but left the door open to the hallway as he was starting to feel a bit scared. He was enjoying himself when eventually he heard loud footsteps coming from the hallway. He nervously cried out,
"Hello? Is someone there?"
Nothing really happened for several minutes until out from the hallway he saw a Japanese man wearing what looked like a World War II private's uniform and was completely covered in bandages, blood, and grime. He looked at DP with a very weary and yet very sad look for a very long time. DP brought up the courage and nervously asked the man,
"What are you doing in my house, mister?"
The man just said nothing and continued walking down the hallway, thinking that the coast is clear and was not hearing any more footsteps. DP quietly got out the bathtub and grabbed a towel and a plunger for a weapon and quickly looked out the hallway and wanted to see if the man was still there. But he was gone. There were no traces of footsteps or any sort of footprints, and he didn't hear anyone running from outside. DP was so shooken up, and he was so scared from this, and then eventually he just realized,
"I think I just crapped myself."
Hey, thank you so much for watching my video. If you like watching these kinds of videos, consider giving me a like, comment, and think about subscribing as well. Also, huge thanks to Darkness Prevails for lending his sultry voice and image for this video, so be sure to do the same for him.
It was a pleasure to take part in this. I hope you enjoyed the show. As always, stay moist.